And?
We're back.
Hey, Mugani.
Hey.
So here we left yesterday.
Yes.
And it's back turn. And I suppose she jumps out?
That's one of the Jozaki possibilities. And actually I was going to show some variations. So let's start with this one.
Okay.
It's quite interesting. So one Jozaki variation goes like this. And black creates some sort of base for him or herself. But in this case, this kind of Jozaki wouldn't be very nice. Do you see why?
Yeah, because the flow of water, white goes into the area that you want to have as black.
That too, but that was not so much why I thought this would be wrong.
Okay.
Mostly it's because of this black stone here. It all has to do with the fact that if white would have stones in this area, and he wants to try to make territory here, then this kind of Jozaki is very interesting, because you can very naturally destroy his potential.
Yeah.
So that would be nice, but now, when you already have so many stones in this area, in the upper part of the board, then as black you actually want to make something here. So when you play a stone on the second line, it's kind of useless, right? Because you have these high stones, and then suddenly one stone on the second line, and this one looks like a very natural way of pushing black down. So this stone actually looks very nice for white now. So this kind of idea is very important to keep in mind. When do I play Jozaki? If I have a stone in this corner, I don't want to play there because it's too low. But if my opponent has a stone there, maybe it's actually nice. So it's something I also said in one of the last reviews. Keep thinking about the stones that are in the other corners when you play a Jozaki in one corner.
Yeah.
Not only the local corner is important, but the whole board.
Yeah.
So this Jozaki wouldn't be that nice now. Another idea would be to play these kind of things. This is also Jozaki, but well, this is kind of complicated, I won't go into this. Yeah, this is sort of a fighting, strange shape Jozaki. Also, you can go into the corner. This actually happened in the game,
okay.
So I will show that in a couple of moves.
Okay.
And what's actually also a very nice idea, which maybe is now the best, is to pincer back as black, which is some other kind of Jozaki. You see this rarely played, but now it's quite interesting.
Yeah, because white don't have really a way to...
Yeah, to capture this. And furthermore, this contributes to the part where
clearly
black really wants to have stones. So, the Jozaki would go something like this. So white still tries to capture black in, but black hanes and white extends. This is again the natural flow. This shape you will see occurring in a lot of standard patterns. And then white goes to here, it's also very big of course. Black goes out, and white can play here. This is the most standard way of playing. Black will do something like this, white will hane. Black can now cross cut. White will hane from this side and sacrifice, because going out is impossible. And create a nice shape over here. Now black has to come back. And this is Jozaki. This is all Jozaki, but this actually looks kind of nice for black now.
How can you remember all this stuff, Morgani?
Well, to be completely honest, I don't remember all of the stuff. I also have to keep myself fresh and sharp before these videos, so I look up all kinds of Jozaki. But some of them I know by heart because I play them quite often.
Okay. Yeah.
So I think it's also partly experience. This Jozaki, for example, I have rarely seen, and when I saw this move by Rita, I was really interested in the position, because it's also a move that me myself, I don't play that often, so I don't know all the variations. Like for example, the basic one where you jump out and you go on the second line, that's one I have seen, you know, very often, so I know it, but I also know that it's not good in the situation. So I was very intrigued by that, and I started to look what could be the best. You know, you can go into the corner, but it's very boring, so maybe this move, and I found that move, and I thought it would be nice to show you guys.
Yeah.
I think it also helped my own game, So I can see that these videos, not only you keep learning, but I also
keep learning. I learn sometimes.
That's good. So yeah, this is quite interesting for Black. I would like to play this. If I would know this during the game, I would be eager to play this variation.
Okay.
So yeah, this didn't happen though. So Black just went into the corner.
By the way, for viewers, what do you think about the sound we hear from upstairs? Because we made broadcasts from the European Go Center the last few months.
Uh-huh.
And now we are demoted to the
to the basement.
The basement, and right upon us is the Japanese children learning to ballet dancing.
Actually, this location is kind of nice because it's the library of the European Go Center. You can see all kinds of Japanese Go books here behind us. Yeah, and it's really like an amazing collection. But yeah, you can hear the people upstairs.
So tomorrow we'll do later. We go there.
Yeah.
And when they're.
Yes.
Sorry for that. So
yeah, I hope the sound doesn't bother you too much.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is the last time you hear it.
Okay. So yeah. Well, back to the game.
So Ulrike took the corner.
Yes.
Solid.
Very solid.
German.
German. This is the German Fusik. So yeah, this is all very standard. Here, and then here.
But this is good, because this is low and has follow-up to play here.
Yes, this kind of move is interesting later. Because Black is strong over here, he has this, so this kind of extension would be nice, and also an attack.
Yeah.
So you're right, it's quite a nice move. Now White has to come back to this shape, because
weirdly,
yes, it's not safe yet. For example, if you have a stone here, you also have the same shape, but now it's easy to connect this stone to this.
Mm-hmm.
You have kind of a mi-ai situation here or here.
Yeah.
But if this stone is higher and also further away, it's not that easy. So you have to be really careful for these kind of attacks by Black. And even this. Or this can be annoying if Black has stones in the other parts of the board. Can be quite a severe attack. So in the Joseki, White can play here, which is well very calm but also very boring and sort of submissive, because you give Black another move. Black has the initiative again. And you can also play this. This is actually what Rita did in the game. Of course, there are all kinds of other things you can do. Sometimes pushing here is also okay. You have to be careful with that, but if you have like a huge moyo, then maybe pushing is nice. But this
She wants to play here, and then there's some like kind of killing move possible.
Yes, if you have this stone, then of course there is this idea again with this move. It's very nice. Another way, which is more common to play, if Black doesn't respond, normally this is the Honte response. So if Black doesn't respond, it's like the same over here.
Yeah.
White plays this move and exchanges this. And this is actually a very nice exchange, because it's difficult for Black to go into this direction now. Even if Black will cut, I think I also showed in one of the other videos, it's not that easy, because, well, if Black will cut on this side, White will just sacrifice the stuff. And make a lot of.
There'll be territory suddenly.
Yes, exactly. And this was already strong by Black, so he's only.
Yeah, 3 points extra at the most.
Very strange, you don't want to play there. And if you cut on the other side, over here, it's also a little bit difficult. Because if White extends, then it will be a fight.
No, this stone is very good placed.
Yes, it can become like an attack on these Black stones. And also White has support on this side, which is very crucial. So yeah, he can just run away here. Something like this actually happened, but a little bit later.
Okay.
Which was quite interesting.
So did Ulrike respond to this move?
No, she did. She played here immediately.
Okay.
Which is, it's also a very nice move. I would think about this kind of thing immediately. Either responding here or playing this low move, because If black doesn't play on this side, then of course white will have a very natural extension.
Yeah, the wall becomes very valuable.
Yes, exactly. So this stone also becomes very nice.
Okay.
It's also very important to emphasize what this stone does, because this would be the Honte move, very solid, and you make yourself very strong, so there's no Aji anymore. But it's also passive, and this stone actually does a lot of things, but also leaves behind some weaknesses. So you can see that it goes towards the center, so it helps this weak group. It also more or less attacks the black group, if it's possible in the future. So it helps in that aspect. Also, there are not that many stones in the center yet, so whoever gets stones towards the center in this stage of the game is happy about it, you know. You want to get some stones in the center. And also, this kind of follow-up, which happens in the game, will contribute to this side, so you're making territory there. This move is very important, and it does a lot of things, whereas this would be too slow.
Yeah, it would do only one thing.
Yes, exactly, just defend.
Ulrike.
Yes, Ulrike played here. So this is like the disadvantage of this move, that now this is more powerful. Because if this is over here, then, yeah. Coming back to this area is of course nonsense, because this is more or less captured and, well, you make yourself very strong, so this attack is not that powerful. But if it's over here, then there are all kinds of possibilities, because later Black can play here, Black can play this kind of move, Black can try this Kazumi. There are all kinds of things possible, even this or this. So, it's difficult for White to find a response here. So first this will exchange now, which is very natural. And then, well, there was another exchange. I said this earlier, Sente. So I have to make a very ugly shape. And even this is also Sente. Yeah, this is kind of painful, because these moves are all for free. And Blank gets this dango, this clump of stones.
Yeah, and this whole group is under attack.
Yes, yes.
You can connect, but yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Maybe later there is some scary stuff going on.
Okay.
And now.
But still, Black is not 35 points behind.
No. Black is actually, I think, leading the game still. Black has a good game. All depends on what will happen now, in the middle stage. So let's see. The next move is very interesting, which White played. And, do you have any ideas?
I would go to 3-3.
Okay, 3-3, here. That's also interesting, because you have a 4-4 point and you have two extensions that are far away from the 4-4 point. So 3-3 is a powerful move, that's true. On the other hand, if you do something like this too early, you strengthen your opponent. So I'm not sure from which side Black will...
That's why it's a good move, because you have to make a choice.
Yes, that's
and
true.
Whatever you choose, there are some disadvantages, so you feel better about your choice.
Okay, but that's you're playing mind tricks.
Yeah, of course.
Okay, well, that's
you have to be sneaky. You told me.
Yeah. That's also part of the game. That's true. but let's see the result. If something would go like this, then the boring way of playing is to just extend here. Not sure about this move, because you have to keep thinking like this. Black played here, so if White now exchanges these things, and it would go, for example, like, like this, and this.
This is like a lost move?
Yes, exactly. So in this situation, if it would be like that, would you want to play here as Black? No, you wouldn't really want to, because it's too close to these stones, and maybe you can play here immediately even, or do something on the outside, make a moyo. So you're right, you have to always keep looking at your own stones, and here this would kind of be a lost move, so it doesn't look too great. So maybe instead of extending, you can also think about double Atari.
Double Hane,
sorry. This wasn't
true. Yeah.
And then it's actually more interesting. If White will sacrifice his group in the corner, then... then this stone might be kind of nice, but you would want it to be here. This would be like the shape point, and this kind of fails because, yeah, if white extends here,
always extend there.
Yeah, but not too soon. It's also yeah, tricky, this kind of timing. When should you do this? Because it can also be a co-threat. If you have a big co, then this might actually be a nice co-threat, and it leaves a lot of other co-threats afterwards. So, yeah, if you want to do something in this area, don't play here first and think, first do that. That's crucial, but don't play it too fast. Because it can also be useful as a co-threat. Now, well, these kind of stones here are more or less sente. There's a lot of Aji. If you have this, then already, yeah, it's really sente.
Yeah.
If you don't come back, the corner will die. So, yeah, and also this jump. I don't know, this stone looks a little bit yeah, useless again. So, you're right. This 3-3 point is interesting, but there's one other possibility that you can block from the other side. So, now we blocked from this side here, towards this direction. But what if you play here? That should be the second thought. If this doesn't work out, then, you know, yeah. So, like this. The first thing you should already kind of think about is that this stone is low. So if you're going to make a moyo here, you need one other move. So you would maybe prefer this to be here already. So again, yeah, this stone looks a little bit, I don't know, not on the right spot.
So this confirms that my instinct was correct.
Yeah, yeah, your Sansan suggestion is quite nice. There are a lot of other possibilities, so I'm not sure if it's a good move. For example, you can also play these kind of things, and also towards the other side. Yeah, which aims at taking sente. Well, there are things like that as well. But well, let's see just the most simple variations. Now, if you play double Hane here, not so sure.
Then you might just play here.
Yes, yes, you can also play this. I kind of wanted to avoid this because there are really, yeah, a lot of variations here. I can show them if you want, but it will be
no,
quite detailed.
No, I'm totally not interested.
Okay.
I am.
Okay, so if black would play here, this move is a counterattack. If you play here, you're aiming at getting stones on this side of the board. So instead of going for the corner or going for this, because you can also take this stone. So this is a counterattack. If this part of the board is very interesting and...
it is?
Yeah, it kind of is. Then, yeah, you can think about that. And then you can play here and cut. However, this is also tricky when there is a stone on the 3-3 line. If there's a stone on the fourth line, this kind of thing works. But if there's actually a stone on the third line over here, or here, or even closer, then this isn't that great for white.
Okay.
And I have to...
Well, but in this case, then, if this doesn't work, then you can play...
Yes, you can also still play there. But then it goes back to, like, getting something in the corner.
Yeah. True.
And it's a little bit submissive because now black has two stones on either side and it's kind of nice.
Okay. Let's go back to the game.
Okay.
We are,
but you don't want to see why this is.
Oh, yeah.
It's very important.
Because it will happen to me, of course.
Okay. So I have to.
You didn't prepare it.
No, but I know it. I should know it.
That's what's something different.
No.
So let's do it. Do that tomorrow. Show me that tomorrow.
Yeah, but we're gonna forget it.
Nah.
Oh, okay, I can show it tomorrow if you want.
Yes,
that's fine.
I would love to see it tomorrow.
Sure.
So that we now continue with the
game.
The game.
All right. So let's see.
Rita obviously didn't play mine.
No, some wasn't played, but it's quite interesting. You can think about this move. It looks kind of nice. I'm not sure if there's some kind of counter for black, but why not? Sansan. I would certainly think about playing Sansan. What Rita did, however, was to play here.
Oh,
this is also very interesting. Normally, you would like to play such a high move when you're making a moyo. So when you're...
Well, this is to prevent black to have like a super nice moyo.
Yes, that's true. So it works
two ways
again, yeah. On the other hand, it's a little bit vague. Black didn't respond here in the game, but...
I would have played like something like here. Is this one really dead? Or?
Oh, that's a little bit strange, yes.
Okay.
Because already have two stones here, so maybe if you want to make something, you want to fence it off like that, or... I don't know, it's difficult to actually grasp territory in this area, but it's also very difficult for your opponent to take it away. Because, like I showed, if black is going through here,
yeah,
it only helps.
Yeah.
So you just get territory for free. And if black is starting to just put stones in your territory there, then...
He will have to run away.
Yes, he's outnumbered and immediately he will have a weak group. So this part of the board is very complicated for both. And in such a situation, it's better to just leave it alone. And yeah, when the game gradually... how do you say this? When it
evolves,
yeah, exactly. When it continues and evolves, then something will happen automatically. So you will just get the right timing to play an important move there.
Okay, and to because this is still kind of weak.
Yes, it's also interesting. But it feels a little bit slow because you have a weak group, and you're right, you want to reinforce your weak groups, of course. You always have to be careful. But reinforcing it now is it's kind of like admitting your defeat, you know, because you already played Tanuki in an earlier stage. And now, this move only gives you some potential here and, destroys black's potential a little bit, because if black would get this move, it would work nice. But on the other hand, black can also gain these kind of moves, and suddenly this IG becomes very problematic, because when black has two stones, this is even more dangerous for white, and also this becomes very big. So white will have basically two problems. If he will invade here, he will not have a chance to defend here, and if he will defend here, then black will take all the territory. So, this kind of move is a little bit too slow and too submissive at this point.
So this move by Rita was not bad at all?
No, it's quite nice. She can also think about Sansan, and maybe this kind of thing is also interesting. It's very slow and, I don't know, it's a little bit submissive, but it's also very strong. So you take a lot of territory here, and whatever black will do, if he will make a moyo, there's still... really a lot of Aji here, sorry for the sound, it's also the basement. If you will play like this, there's a lot of Aji because of this stone on the second line. This also again has to do with the straight lines that are very effective in Go. If you go down here, it not only has strength towards this side and takes all its territory, but it also aims at all this potential on the left part of the line. So it goes to the right, to the lower part of the board, and to the left, to the upper part of the board. And this is also something that's very very helpful. A lot of times when players have... for example, let's say black has some construction over here with some stones, and he has a stone here, and this is also black. And as white, you want to separate the two groups. Now, what a lot of players do wrong is that they either play like this, or like this to separate black. But this is again the same idea. If you play over here, you only go for this area, and if you play here, you only attack that area. But a very natural way is to play in between, in the middle. It's again the same line, because it goes both ways. You prevent black from connecting, and you separate his groups, and not only do you attack this part, you also attack this part with all the Aji over here. So, when you try to separate groups, think about straight lines. Think about cutting in a straight way. Not going one direction or the other, going both by going straight.
So the theme of this week is straight.
I guess. Yeah, I just by teaching one of my students on KTS, I discovered this kind of thinking. I mean, I apply it in my games, but then I was teaching him and I was telling him about why this move was wrong, and yeah, I thought it might be very nice for other Q players as well to realize this during your games.
But I even think for Dant players that sometimes you know it's something,
yes,
but without putting it into words. If you are able to put something into words,
mm-hmm,
to visualize it by words, then it's much easier to adapt.
Sure, yeah, I think so. Yeah, this kind of thing is also interesting for dumb players, that's true. Yeah.
I think this talking to yourself and explaining to yourself,
uh-huh,
is the reason why you won our game. Because I was not bad at
all,
I think.
Yes.
But you kept on reasoning and,
mm-hmm,
talking to yourself, and I only,
yeah,
played, and then suddenly, mm-hmm, you lose the whole picture.
Yes,
and
yes.
You won because you kept the pitch on the whole board and the whole game.
Yeah, and usually you have to do that in your brain. I'm also doing that, like not talking out loud, but basically talking in my head during the game. Like, okay man, where do you want to play? Is this big? Is this part of the board big? Is this weak? Is that strong? So yeah, you're right. I keep kind of checking myself, you know? Oh, I want to do that move. Is that really a good move? You know, you have to, yeah, like a computer almost, keep checking your own reasonings, because yeah, humans make a lot of mistakes, and yeah, I think that's the way to progress, to keep checking your own ideas and not become too comfortable with what you already know.
Yeah, so don't play automatically like I do, but
yes,
every move again, try to reason it out.
Yes, it's a very nice tip. Okay, so enough about this straight,
yeah,
lines idea.
So Rita plays here.
Yes, Rita plays here. And now, as black, I would really like to play here. It looks very natural, and just make a lot of territory. At the same time, the sun point is still annoying. So I think now would probably be a good opportunity to play there. I'm not sure though, because now black can probably block from this side. But anyway, this kind of shape is very natural. Yeah, I don't know, looks nice. What black did, however, she played here. And, well, I'm not completely sure, to be honest, about how the game followed. I'm not sure if this kind of cut is okay for black. She played here and...
very good move.
Yeah, of course, if you push here twice, you have to cut on this side. It's the only move, it's a very good move. But on the other hand, it gets really complicated now. And when you're playing a stronger opponent, 2Q is playing 4 Dan in this example, then you really have to be careful with making it complicated, because that's what your opponent wants. The 4 Dan is better at reading, and better at local crazy fighting than the 2Q. So it's also a tip for people who are playing handicap games against their teachers or against their friends that are stronger. Try to keep the game simple. Of course, cut when you have to, you know. Don't let weak groups combine. But don't make it too complicated, because the basics, like the fundamentals of Go, are about,
yeah, but you don't understand how difficult is what you're saying.
Yeah.
Don't make it too complicated.
Yeah,
what
okay.
is two?
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, okay.
If I'm able to decide what is too complicated or not, then I would be much stronger.
Yes, that's true. I'll try to...
Yeah, talk your way out of this one.
Try to make easy shapes, like...
Yeah, but not too easy, because...
Okay, of course I don't know what to say to this, but... Just when you know you like fighting, for example, like you do, you're a really crazy fighter. Just when you play somebody strong, take it easy. Because of course you like fighting and you're reasonably good at it, but against a stronger player, for sure you will get crushed in a fighting sequence. So if you really want to learn and you're playing a stronger opponent, try to first defend and take it really easy, take calm moves. And if you're sure that you're completely alive in an area, then fight. Yeah, of course it's like the principle that also accounts for normal games, you know, even opponents. But in handicap games, it's especially important. My teacher, there I go again, my teacher in China also told me this. Because I was playing on 2 or 3 handicaps with him. And whenever he had the chance, he had the opportunity, he did a complicated move. And immediately, the positions just gradually became better for him, like really fast. So, I don't know how to explain taking it easy on the board, but first strengthen yourself. Make easy shapes, take corners, try to be efficient with your stones, because you already have handicapped stones. And don't fight too much if you don't have to.
Shall we make a special on handicap one time?
Yeah.
So don't do it now, but save this.
Sure.
All this wisdom for us for later, and we do like a special handicap week or something like this.
Yeah, sounds cool.
Okay.
I have some nice games from when I was in China, and I think I could show some examples of how my teacher crushed me in handicap games. Would be nice.
Okay.
Okay. So let's get back to this.
shall we otherwise go to finish tomorrow?
Okay.
Yeah. That we finish now and then we leave the music for what it is.
Okay.
Because it annoys me a little bit, I'm sorry.
That's okay.
And so I want to thank you.
Thanks. Yeah.
And I thank you. And we go. Bye.
Bye bye.